Did you imagine The Witcher would turn into this global phenomenon and you'd be here at the premiere of season 3?
No, not at all. I mean, I mean, it's like any job. You don't know how it's going to be received. I knew there was a huge fan base, books and game. I hadn't read or played them, so I was kind of coming into it fresh. So I didn't know what was going to happen when it was about to drop. So yeah, that kind of explosion from season 1 and 2 and now here, it's so brilliant to have our own kind of fan base and bringing in other people who were like me, maybe they hadn't seen it before. It's incredible. It's always like to come here and see all these people. It's so fantastic.
What has been your biggest lesson that you've been able to take home from filming The Witcher?
Good question. I've never done such a big budget show. I've never done such an ensemble piece before, so I think it's a different discipline to doing kind of small budget indies, one episode here and there. So it's been my learning curve, you know. I've learned from such great actors, and it's been 4 or 5 years of learning from these people. A lot of screen time, you know, a lot of input, like just watching people do what they do, you know, and talking to people and people who have been in the game a long, long time. So I've learned a huge deal.
Who was the person you had to put out fires on the most?
Tris. Yeah, her hair is huge, and she's constantly walking near flames. So I saved her a few times, definitely. They can expect bigger and better than the last season. New characters, character development. Just to step up. I mean, there's so much going on. It's hard to know what to say because you don't want to ruin it. So I think, you know, just expect bigger and better.
What about your character specifically?
I think his journey develops. I think it's been a continuation from season 1, actually. He's still got questions that need to be answered. And he's relentless, you know. He's set on his goals, and he has answers that I think that have an impact on so many people, and so many people within the continent. So you'll see him develop, you'll see him keep searching and build new relationships, make new relationships. There are exciting things for Istrid. I don't want to ruin him, but you see a big development in him. It's a dream, you know. You don't know what they're going to throw at you when you're reading it. And it's one thing reading it. You know, you read it and say, wow, that. How the hell are we going to do that? And then when you walk into the set, you think, oh, well, that's incredible. And then you add on all the extras and everything, and it's what you want as an actor, you know. You want to be thrown into something, and you want to be immersed in it as much as you can, and they really let you do that. So, yeah, you look out for this in season 3.
What about working with Henry? I mean, he obviously seems to live and breathe. He's so embedded in this character's fantasy. So sad to see him go, but also excited for Liam coming on board.
Yeah, absolutely. It's very sad. I mean, he's been a great, great Geralt, and, you know, he's developed this really kind of brilliant character, this iconic character already, you know, and we've had a really lovely working relationship. And so we're always making each other laugh, and he's so giving as an actor, you know. It's going to be really sad to see him go, but I hope I pass cross again, you know. What are you doing?
I'm peeing in it.